Hello everyone, Pani Coffee here, and today I'm showing you the process of modifying my painting station to this new, more roomy kind of setup. Computer, coffee for two. Okay, so the main reason why I modified again my workspace is to simply make more room for unboxing and painting, putting my stuff basically, and also making it a bit tidier, because if you didn't know, my workspace is actually in the living room itself, so I can't afford to let paint bottles lying around or the paint rack. Just, you know, it was helpful as a painter, but it just looks messy, and so I decided to hide those under shelves and just pick what I need so that the table is more tidy. I don't have paint bottles lying around or tools lying around, you know. I want it tidy. And all the clutter just makes me feel suffocated, so I wanted to clear that out and I just concentrate on the project. I can move it safely and without much effort. There she goes. Perhaps the most latest addition to my workshop is this portable spray booth from Aircom. This is actually great because there's no venting needed. I just need to put space behind, and it has a filtration system. For my part, I only use water-based acrylics. I don't use a lot of solvent in spraying, so this should be a good setup for me. I'm not sure how well this will work for those with solvents. So if you use lacquer, for example, that might be a different case because you would still smell it. So all in all, this is a great setup for those of you having a small space and no big windows to open. This works well because you don't need it. You don't need to vent it out a window. You just need to make sure that the filters are changed regularly and it will filter out the overspray. And you know, once you're done, you can just open a window, but you don't have to have it open all the time. It's just after. There might be some particles left, but it's very minimal because the filter just takes off a lot of it. So thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed this process video, and I hope that this has inspired you in any way to make your own modifications to your workshop, workspace that fits your needs. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to put them in the comments. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you next week. See ya!